click the start button and then type system configuration or msconfig from the search field. And then after that, select the system configuration tool from the search result. Once you've opened this tool, click the boot tab and then go under where it says boot options and then check save boot. So now by doing this, when you restart your PC, Windows will automatically boot to safe mode. And this is great because let's say you have to diagnose something that requires you to restart your computer many times, Windows will always automatically boot to safe mode. But that itself is a problem because Windows will always automatically boot to safe mode. And surely at one point you're going to want the normal boot again. Happily, you can always go back to the system configuration utility and then uncheck safe boot under boot options again. The second way to boot to safe mode is via the system settings. To do that, click the start button and then type advanced startup options in the search field. And then choose change advanced startup options in the search results. And this will take you directly to these options from the settings. So now go all the way to the bottom under where it says advanced startup and click restart now. After restarting your PC, you will notice this blue choose an option screen. From there, select troubleshoot. And then select advanced options. And then select startup settings. And then you will notice all that will happen once you restart your computer again. And so to confirm, click restart once more. After restarting your PC this time, now you will notice this startup settings screen. From there, choose option 4, 5 or 6 to boot to safe mode. The third way is via the signin page. Let's say for example you are about to enter your password or PIN to enter Windows 10. Well, from there you can boot to safe mode as well. All you have to do is press and hold shift and then click the power button and then choose restart, of course while holding shift. And then after restarting your PC, you'll notice that once again it boots the choose in option screen. From there, choose troubleshoot, choose advanced options, choose startup settings, and then confirm by clicking restart once more. And then on the next screen, choose options 4, 5 or 6 to boot to safe mode. The fourth and last way is from scratch. Let's say for example your computer is totally off. Even in such circumstances, it is still possible to boot to safe mode. This may seem a little tedious, but bear with me. Step 1, hit the power button to turn on your computer. Now immediately on the first sign your computer has started, you might see for example a logo of the manufacturer and so on. And now for step 2, immediately after that, press and hold the power button again for about 10 seconds and this will turn off your computer. Alright, now for step 3, repeat these procedures again. Turn it on and then look for a sign that Windows has started and then hit the power button for about 10 seconds. And finally, this time hit the power button again to turn on the computer and this time it will finally boot to the Windows recovery environment. And then from there you are going to see the same choose an option screen. Of course, choose troubleshoot, advanced options and so on. And that's it. These are the different ways of booting to safe mode on Windows 10.